An Olympic Games has thousands of stakeholders, bringing with them tons of specialist equipment and baggage. Have you ever wondered how this vast amount of people and equipment arrives smoothly and efficiently into the host country and onward to their accommodation? And how they are able to seamlessly pack up and move back to their port of departure when it's time for them to leave? It's a huge logistical operation that demands a high level of detailed planning, and it has a major impact on the Olympic experience for the athletes attempting their shot at glory. The arrivals and departures function coordinates the design and implementation of an end-to-end service from the arrival gateway through to every stakeholder's accommodation site and back again.
The coordination and the cooperation between transport, arrival departures and logistics, it's always, I think, challenging if you only have a look at one of these topics and you don't then see the links. And I think it's very important that you cannot split one from the other.
By having an arrivals and departures team that consistently pulls together the focus on the actual experience across all those different operators and all those different areas, it then helps to simplify the end-to-end experience, and that helps make it more efficient and effective for the person arriving, and therefore positive.
Knowing all your stakeholders, what they are bringing, and their key requirements is crucial.
Communication is the most important thing to do before the games time, because we have to communicate a lot with each stakeholder, like NOCs, of course, media, and other clients. And we have to figure it out what they want first, then we can prepare for what we can do.
It's always very helpful to learn from past games and to speak to NOCs, bigger ones, smaller ones, what's their needs, how do they organize themselves.
You need to make sure that the first experience they have is a good one, so that it's a comfortable, smooth, successful process. It doesn't happen by accident. It does need to be thought about.
The plan is only successful if everyone agrees to it, and then everyone works together when the operational reality may be different to the plan. It's a massive team effort.
We had a special committee led by the government in which all agencies involved in the Olympic effort were regularly meeting. So every single aspect of the games were discussed, evaluated, and shared with all major immigration, customs, and public entities.
출도차 서비스는 다른 일반 물류하고 다르게 시간에 정해져 있고 한정된 시간에 많은 자원이 투입이 되어야 된다는 게 다릅니다. 그리고 시간을 늦추거나 지연을 할 수가 없는 부분이기 때문에 그 처해져 있는 시간을 바로 신속하게 처리하는 게
To be a good partner, it just means that we need to be talking all the time about what our options are, how we can actually help facilitate the OCOG's plan. So when we ask the questions, it's not to try to pin them down, it's just to explore possibilities.
Integrating the airport operations plan into the end-to-end arrival and departure plans is a key element for the organizing committee, agencies, airlines, and airport operators.
It's always important to have trolleys around or to get the support from the logistics people and minimize the time they had to spend at the airport so that they could really board the bus as soon as possible and then leave.
It's not just about arrivals. Departures creates a unique challenge for an Olympic Games.
There's always assumption that departures happens at the end, but indeed they happen the whole way through. And so your arrivals and departures team need to be ensuring that the arrivals and departures of today are happening, but then you're also planning for tomorrow and planning for the next phase of operation.
The peak departure day will be the operation that stretches the team the most. A strong departure plan is an absolute must. Experience has shown that you can't manage your peak departure day without operating remote check-in, with off-airport processing at the Olympic Village as a minimum.
Why it's so important? Because the athletes are going to have all the boarding passes ready, all the bags are going to be already back tagged. So by the time the people come to the airplane, it's just a matter of a normal boarding process.
Ultimately, it's about putting processes and systems in place, testing them, and communicating them.
We did one full test, what we call end-to-end, from arrivals at the airport until the arrivals at the village, at their condo, and then departing from the condo back to the airport. And then we did a test with switching like 3 regular departures and 1 remote check-in. We brought a lot of airline companies, because one thing is showing them in a presentation, but then the other thing is seeing personally how it is.
Well, it's really important that the OCOG's planning is very specific, and they can communicate to us as early as possible what their plan is, whether it's using trains or buses. We would love it a year ahead of time.
Arrivals and departures for an Olympic Games is not business as usual. You need to be prepared and you need to be ready. This is especially true with handling sports equipment, where the baggage and volumes is like no other event in the world.
Of course, everything depends as well on the qualifications, so it's very difficult to say in advance what kind of equipment and how much you will bring if you don't know how many athletes will join. That's one of the challenges we have.
Competition schedule is being changed every day, and sometimes athletes got injured, and sometimes athletes don't stay in the village. There's a lot of unexpected things. During games time, it's more important to communicate all the time and every day.
The arrivals and departures team plays a critical role in the running of the games, helping to make sure that the people who arrive full of hopes and dreams begin their Olympic experience in the best way, so that they can just maybe depart as a medalist, as well as an Olympian.